Hey there, welcome to Things Dan's Way. So today I have a decision to make. Should I stick with a portable generator like this BLUETTI here that's completely packaged, ready to go, has all the features, this nice thing, or should I have more fun? And should I take a box like this and fill it up with components and batteries and build my own generator? I have a purpose behind this, and specifically it's with my Traeger. You see, what I want to do is I want to strap my Traeger to the back of my truck on a rack, and I want to drive up into the mountains, and when I arrive, I want to have freshly cooked meat. That sounds ridiculous, I get it, but it's just what I want to do. Now, my buddy Nate, I can put a link up here to his stuff, he'll be in the description down below, and he drove from the ocean out to like Palm Springs or something, and the whole time in the back of his truck, he had a Traeger going with like a portable power station. And I'm like, man, that's a lot of fun. I want to do that, but I want to take it a step beyond. I want to kind of build my own unit. So this video is going to be about the difference between building a unit like this and buying the parts and kind of showing the price difference between the two, the kind of fun to be had as far as building it, and what the trade-offs are between a roll-your-own generator and a off-the-shelf pre-built unit like one of these. So if you don't watch that, don't go away. This is Doing Things Dan's Way. Okay, so clearly I could just buy a pre-built unit like this. This guy is about $279 on Amazon today. Of course, I'll put links down below if you want to jump on any of the products I talk about today. But this one's $279. It has about 450 watt hours of power in it. It has a couple of 700 watt outlets, except each one total, like it's really 700 watts max. So it has a couple AC outlets on it. It has a couple USB Type-C ports and one Type-A port. Of course, it has a 12 volt outlet for a pump or something like that that's 12 volt when you're camping. It has a solar input, and so it can take in some solar at 200 watts max, and also a max of 28 volts DC, which kind of limits your choices a little bit. It does have a nice display, which tells you the current state of charge, as well as the power input and output from the solar input and the AC output. And of course, on the side, it has a few more ports. Over here, it has just a standard 110 wall charging port. And this can charge up this battery in a few hours, so that's pretty great. There's nothing on the back. And the right side only has a fan. So that's pretty much it. It is a nice, complete package. It weighs maybe about 20 pounds or so. So if I was to take this $279, what could I do for maybe half that price or somewhere thereabouts? So let's look at some parts and pieces that we could put into a box like this that I just got at Home Depot that would be something very similar to this with maybe a little bit better, a little worse features. Let's check it out. So over at Home Depot, I picked up this like $12 anvil box. It's a nice size. It has a nice handle. It is plenty big inside for the parts I'm going to be putting in. And this is not going to be like one of those pro-built units where like everything's been machined and 3D printed and all that. This is kind of like, let's kind of throw the parts together and have it work and call it good enough. So obviously the two biggest pieces of this puzzle are going to be the batteries and the inverter. So for the batteries, I picked out a couple of ECOFLOW. These are 12 volt, 15 amp hour batteries. They are pretty solidly built, although they don't weigh a ton because this is lithium iron phosphate, so these are safe. Two of these in parallel will give you 30 amp hours, so 30 amps of output. So for the inverter, this Best Tech 400 watt true sine wave inverter was just a really nice looking package when I saw it online. Again, I picked all this stuff up on Amazon just to make it easy. It has all the ports on one face, and the backside just has power in and a on-off switch. So clearly we're stopping here at 400 watts, where this one here has a 700 watt rating. So that's obviously a step down. I'm thinking about the kinds of loads that I'm going to be putting on this, and the 400 watt number feels about right for what I'm doing. And I would have to go to one more battery to get the amp hour from the BMS in here. To get up to the 50 amp range, which is what I would need to get to the 700 watts. So this is a step down. So clearly we're going to say, you know, this one gets the win for that. But this is probably going to be a lot cheaper solution. So just keeping track of costs so far, we have $10, $12 box. The batteries are $35 a piece right now. So the inverter currently is $48. Okay, so the next step that this unit has that I need to add to this idea is a battery charger. So in this case, I found a real simple little 3-amp charger that has mounting holes on it, which I like because now I can actually mount the thing to the side of the box. This is a 3-amp charger, so it'll take, if these batteries are fully flat, it would take 10 hours to charge up this whole battery system, which seems really, really slow, which it's a bit of a concern to me, but then again, in an overnight charge situation, that's fine. These are $19 right now at Amazon. And then for the solar charger, what I really wanted was just a simple PWM charger that actually looks just like this. This one here actually has a bezel front on it and all the connections are on the back. So many of the chargers I saw had the connections like exposed and visible. So if I mounted it to here, you'd have wires that were actually going back down in the box or going out to the solar panel. This one is designed where you cut a perfect square and the wires end up inside the box. So I thought this was, it's really pretty actually. Love it. There was an all black version too. So this one I'll be able to cut a nice opening and drop it right in. And this again, I think it was $20. So very, very reasonable price. Now, lastly, I picked up this. I'm debating whether I use this or not because the inverter already has one USB Type-C and one Type-A on it, as well as the two AC outputs. And the solar charger does let you read voltage. So this little guy, while nice, and you could be able to turn on the outlets here, it would show you the display of what the voltage is on the batteries. It would give you two Type A's and one Type C, and it would give you a standard cigarette lighter 12-volt adapter. So at this point, I'm debating whether I'll have space in the box for this and whether I really need this, because I already have some of these connections already and I can get the information about the voltage. So this is kind of up for grabs right now. And this I think was $20. So not bad. It's actually built quite nicely. I really like it. I might use it for another system I'm working on as well. So anyway, that's in the mix. Okay, so adding all this up, and I'll put a list here of all the components, I'm looking at right around $180 worth of parts for all these pieces here versus $280 for this unit. Okay, so looking at these side by side, you can see the difference in price as well as all the different features kind of broken down side by side. So the homemade charger at $200 is definitely not quite as nice as the BLUETTI system in terms of total output power. And it's of course a little bit larger package and you got to build it yourself, but there's fun to be had and it's actually cheaper. The other option here is ECOFLOW 2. Which has a smaller battery, but otherwise very similar features. So let me know, which of these two would you think would be the best value?
I am gonna go ahead and just build this. I'm just gonna hyperlapse through this and maybe stop a couple times to talk about things. So enjoy this 10-second build montage. Nice and tight.
Okay, well, now we have this box all built. What do you guys think? I have the solar controller on this side. I have the inverter outputs here. So I have two AC outlets and the two USBs. On the back side, I have the switch to turn that on. I can flip that little switch on now. And then on this side, I have the USB ports and the 12-volt cigarette lighter type output as well. A voltage meter, which is real nice to be able to just spy on what's happening. And then I can turn all this off with this switch here. Inside with the tray in here, I just have like a couple, some charge cables sitting here to charge up devices with. I have the solar input sticking out that I can plug a solar panel into. And then I have the AC charge cable here that I can pull out and use. So at the beginning of this build, I said I wanted to power my smoker with this, and this was kind of the reason that I built it up. So let's go out to the backyard.
Okay, and finally we are out here at the Traeger with some meat, with our own portable power source hanging out in the backyard. So I got this guy, I have him turned on. You can see the lights on. He's sitting at 13.5 volts right now. Let's go ahead and plug him in. Okay, our Traeger comes alive. I'm gonna set this to around 200 degrees. and fire it up, and we'll let this guy get up to temperature before we put the meat on. Okay, so at this point, the unit is using the heater to heat up the pellets, and so this is where it's running about 280 watts. But then eventually, once the fire is lit, all the smoker's going to need is like 50 watts to run the blower, 45 watts, and then another 20 or so to run the auger as it feeds additional material. Once that gets up to temperature, we'll throw the meat on. Okay, so we got ourselves up to 203, so I'm going to go ahead and throw this meat on. I put this into probe mode, so that way I can see, where it says P here, I can see exactly the temperature of the meat. But once this gets back up to about 132, 135, something like that, I'll pull the meat off, let it rest, and we will have an awesome lunch. Okay, we are right at just over 130 degrees, so I'm gonna go ahead and pull it off and cover it in foil and let it rest for about 20 minutes. Then we'll cut it open and see what it looks like.
That's what we got right there. Let's go let him rest.
15 minutes later.
Let's dive into this and see how it is. Decent little smoke ring there. Definitely on the rare side. Oh, yum.
What do you think? Would you build one of these for yourself to do this? Would you do this at all with the smoker? Would you just buy one of the off-the-shelf units? Let me know in the comments below. Of course, links below for everything, including any discount codes I got from manufacturers on these things. Hit up these other videos and smash on my face to subscribe. We'll see you next time, guys. Be blessed and know God loves you. Ha ha.